Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain.
Hello, a very good day to you. My name is Sister Temi Tayo. I'm a Christian content creator, and I'm here once again to share from the Open Heavens Daily Devotional compiled by the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. And the reason I'm sharing from this particular Christian book is because the Lord instructed me to do so as I prepare to enter into the year 2020. So this is my fourth year of sharing the Open Heavens, and that's why we call it season four. And all those videos from 2020 are uploaded on my YouTube channel. My handle on YouTube is Temi Agedo, which is right on the screen. I would encourage you to visit my channel, not only to view those old Open Heavens videos, which are a great study guide, but most importantly, to view the Open Heavens for the current day. And I know that will bless you exceedingly. And while you're on my channel, very important, don't forget to subscribe. And God bless you. The Lord bless you as you do. Now, Pastor Adeboye led me to Christ in October 1997, a few years back when I was in the University of Lagos, Nigeria, in West Africa. And Pastor usually gives you a few scriptures from the Bible and a memory verse, and that helps you to understand the body of the text. Praise God. So today is Thursday, November the 9th, and the title of today's daily devotional is When God Commends You. When God Commends You. And the scriptural reading for today is Psalm 8, verses 1 to 6. Psalm 8, verses 1 to 6. I'm going to be reading from the traditional King James Version, and thus goes the reading of God's Word. Psalm 8, verse 1 to 6, and the title is again is When God Commends You. Okay, so it says, O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth, who has set thy glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of babes and sucklings hast thou ordained strength because of thine enemies, that thou mightest still the enemy and the avenger. When I consider thy heavens, the work of thy hands, the moon and the stars which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and son of man that thou visitest him? For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. Thou madest him to have dominion over the work of thy hands. Thou hast put all things under his feet. Praise God. Just six verses. And the reason why this psalm is so popular is because out of the mouth of Jesus Christ quoted from it. He said, out of the mouth of babes and sucklings, thou hast ordained strength. This was during the triumphant entries when the children were shouting, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. And the Pharisees, went off in flames, and they said, oh, you stop the children from stop them from shouting. And Jesus Christ said, do you not know that is written in the law that out of the mouth of babes and sucklings thou has ordained strength? And then there's the first verse says, Oh Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. You know, that's a song we used to sing in church. We still sing it, you know. Oh Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. How excellent is your name. And many of us know that song. Yes, it's gotten from Psalm 8, verse 1. And this is written a Psalm of David. And he was just, you know, amazed at God, you know, and how, you know, God created the heavens. He says, you know, when we think about man, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels. Now, the this verse was also quoted in the book of Hebrews by Paul, you know, and the word there is that, you know, it says in verse 5 that thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, but actually, the original translation says thou hast made him a little lower than the Elohim. You know, and that has crowned him with glory and honor. Praise God. When God commends you. Today again is November the 9th, when God commends you. And the memory verse is taken from the book of Psalms, same book of Psalms 145 verse 8. Psalm 145 verse 8. And it says, the Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and of great mercy. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and of great mercy. Oh, there's no one long-suffering like God, because when you read the Old Testament and see what the children of Israel were doing, you know, and how God bore with them, you know, bore their craziness for so long, you know, because he loves us with an everlasting love. He's long-suffering, very slow to anger, God is very slow to anger. The Bible says he does not deal with us after our sins, and he does not punish us according to our iniquities. If God should mark iniquities, the psalmist said, who shall stand? None of us shall be able to stand. For God is gracious. He's good, and his mercies endure forever. He's good and kind. He's very slow to anger. I remember in the book of Ezekiel, you know, God said that, you know, he's righteous all his life, and he does something wrong, you know, and he dies in that sin, he will go to hell, and his righteousness that he had done previously will not be remembered. But if a sinner, you know, should sin and then he becomes righteous and then he dies in his righteousness, he will, you know, he'll be accepted into heaven. So the people said, ah, God, your ways are not equal. You know, because, and God said, my ways are equal. You know, I am equal. My ways are equal. It's you whose ways are not equal. And you know how God is so merciful that the most wicked king in the Bible, as far as I'm concerned, is Ahab, who was married to Jezebel. And you know, he killed Naboth, did so many bad things, brought in the Baal worship. The Bible says he did more wickedly than all the other kings before him. And, you know, when God sent a prophet to him that he was going to die, now he was going to die, he now repented, you know. Oh, and God said, look at Ahab, you know. He's repented of what I said I was going to do to him. He said, I will not punish him. The punishment that I had for him, it will not come in his time. It will come in the days of his children. This was Ahab, the most wicked king ever. You know, he had killed prophets of God, you know, and because he showed... he showed remorse. God forgave him. God is very easy to please. God is so easy to please. He's so good and kind. When God commends you, now every now and then God commends his children. He tells them that he's pleased with them. And when this happens to you, pastor says, don't become full of yourself because he's only being gracious. The Bible says that God is perfect and he expects perfection in Matthew 5:48. Matthew 5:48 says that Jesus Christ said, which says that be ye perfect, even as your Father which is in heaven is perfect. Now, pastor says that Ephesians 5:25-27 makes it clear that Jesus Christ is coming back for a bride without blemish or wrinkle. Pastor says, are you perfect yet? If God says, well done, my son, you're doing a great job, he's only being gracious. In Job 1:8, he said Job was a perfect and upright man. But then in Job 30:1, Job said things that a just man shouldn't. And when God called him as just, he was only being gracious to him. In Numbers 12:3, it is written concerning Moses that he was the meekest man on the earth, but he was well known for his violent temper. God's commendation is only an extension of grace. You must never let it get into your head. If you do, you will soon realize that you are nowhere in the first place. And you see, God is gracious. God is gracious. And, you know, as I was reading this, I just remembered Lot. You know, Lot was such an ungrateful person. He was ungrateful. I don't like his character. But then God still called him righteous. You know, and when Abraham prayed for God to deliver Lot from Sodom, God sent his angels to deliver him. You know, because he's a merciful God. But what pastor is telling us here is that, you know, he's using he said to us that Jesus Christ said that we should be perfect as our Father in heaven is perfect, and that just like we commend our children when they do right, God commends us too, you know, and appreciates us. He commends us for a job well done. But pastor is saying here, don't let it get into your head. Don't let it get into your head. He's saying that, you know, in the book of Job, for example, you know, God commended Job. He said to the, you know, sons of God, have you considered, he said to Satan, have you considered my servant Job, that there's none like him in all the earth, a perfect man, one that hates evil and that eschews evil and does good. So he was commending Job, and the thing got into Job's head, you know. And the next thing we know, Job messed up in chapter 30, such that God said, who is this that darkeneth words without knowledge, you know. So one minute he was commending Job, and Job had forgotten that, you know, God was just being gracious. When God commends us, God is just being gracious and merciful and kind. Don't let it get into your head, okay? Same with, you know, Moses. God said to Moses, when his junior, his siblings were chiding with him, you know, and they were saying, are you the only one that God called? God called us to, because we were angry with Moses because he went to marry an Cushite or an Ethiopian woman. And so Aaron and Miriam, they were, you know, like sibling, they were angry with him. They were like, are you the only one that God has called, Moses? You know, and God heard it. And God heard it, you know, so God listens to our conversations. And God was angry with them and said to them, you know, were you not afraid to talk to Moses, my servant? He said, with other prophets, I speak to them in visions and in dreams, but not so with Moses, one with whom I speak mouth to mouth. And the Bible says God's presence departed and was very angry with them. He said, Moses, there's none faithful in all my house like Moses. He called Moses faithful. But Pastor is saying that when God commends us, he's only being gracious. Don't let it get into your head. Because the next thing we know is that Moses had broken the Ten Commandments when he came down from the mountain and saw the golden calf. He could not control his anger. He had a very violent temper. Yeah, the Bible says he was the meekest person on earth. So he said, Pastor says, God's commendation is only an extension of grace. You must not let it get into your head. If you do, you'll soon realize that you're nowhere in the first place. You know, so when God commends us, don't let it get into your head. Receive it with thanks. I mean, and you see, it's God is gracious. The memory verse says God is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger, and of great mercy. God is so merciful. And you know, that's why the song, the psalmist kept singing, God is good and his mercies endured forever. We do what we do because of God's spirit that is at work in us. So we even should be thanking him that, God, you chose me to use me, you know, and give him thanks, because we cannot do it without him anyway. Amen. Now, the Bible says in Romans 9:15-16, for he said to Moses, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy, and I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion. So then it is not of him that willeth, of him that runneth, but of God that showeth mercy. The other thing that happened is that as I read this, I realized that this understanding can come only through experience of working with God. You know, so Pastor is able to tell us this is, he's pulling from his wealth of wisdom, you know, from his long-term walk with God, for him to realize this. So he's saying that, you know, reminding us that God will have compassion on whom he will have compassion, and he will have mercy on whom he will have mercy. So it is not of him that willeth, of him that runneth, of God that showeth mercy. It's not the works and effort that you put in that will make you justified. It is true that you must put in effort. If not, you'll not even have the chance to be commended at all. But the effort does not justify you. It's not by power or by might. It is only God's mercy that justifies us. Never forget that. You know, there's a man of God that prays a lot, you know, and he'll say, oh Lord, show me mercy. You know, because we are what we are by the grace of God and by his mercy. You know, we stand by the mercy and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so he says, when God commends a person, the fellow's efforts will yield greater results than his actions or his or her actions. You know, some people think that, oh, I got where because I cooperated with God, it's my effort. You know, I tried, I did something. Yes, you must do something, because if you don't put in effort, then you won't even be able to, you won't be commended. There will be no option to be commended. But it's God's mercy, you know. This God's mercy, God's appointment that makes it possible for us to be what we are. It is only because God decided to have mercy on us. Don't begin to think that you are perfect, because you are not. Rather, thank him for his mercy. Acknowledge your weaknesses before him and even before people. Ascribe all glory to him and not to your efforts, because without him, you can do nothing. Without Jesus Christ, we can do nothing. John chapter 15, verse 5. No, don't. I'm very careful of flatterers, people that flatter. You know, they want to sing your praise. Maybe you've had a very great program, souls were saved. You know, be very careful of people that flatter. May God bind all the flatterers in Jesus' name. You know, so don't think that you are so much. The Bible says in Romans 12:3, which is a prayer I pray all the time, that Lord, help me not to think of myself more highly than now, but help me to think soberly as you've given unto me the measure of faith. We must think soberly. It's by God's mercy that, you know, we were chosen. And we must ascribe all glory to him. Don't take the praises of men, you know, because they can make, pastor, a lot of flatterers, you know. And we must shut up the mouth of flatterers. And Pastor is saying that ascribe all glory to him and not to your effort, because without him, you can do nothing. Without Jesus Christ, we are nothing. The reason why people are known, somebody maybe from some back village somewhere is known, is because God selected them by his mercy. You know, God selected us by his mercy. You know, he saw so many around and then he picked me to shut the open heavens on you to be by his mercy. And like I look at it and I'm not really able to, on my own. But then the Spirit of God has so helped me that, when I stand with pick up an open heavens, I'm able to divide it asunder. It's not by power or by might. It was, I understand that it's the anointing. When God sends you, he gives you the ability, supernatural ability to do what he has called you to do. Like Samson, Samson got carried away with his strength. He never gave glory to God. He never acknowledged the fact that a normal man cannot carry the gates of a city up a hill. He never for once said, "Lord, thank you for giving me this supernatural strength. Let me use for your glory. Thank you, Lord." May God show us, continue to show us mercy. His mercy is endured forever and he's good. And this is the Old Testament. So talking about the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be God. The key point is God's commendation is a call to be more humble and to work harder. I love that scripture in Romans 12:3. It says we should not think of ourselves more highly than we ought, but we should think soberly as God has dealt unto us the measure of faith when God commends you. Praise God. And may God help us to be doers, hearers, and doers of his word. In Jesus' name, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you because you're faithful. Thank you, Almighty God, because we are what we are by your great grace towards us. Thank you for your mercies because you're good. Thank you for because you're good and your mercies endured forever. Thank you because you have loved us with an everlasting love. Thank you because we are what we are by your grace. And without you, we can do nothing. We know and we declare that without, except God builds the house, the laborers labor but in vain. We thank you, Father, because you alone are the glory and the lifter up of our head. We give you praises, Almighty God. We thank you for choosing us. Thank you for choosing us because you said in your word in John 15 that we didn't choose you, you chose us. Thank you for choosing us to be your children. Thank you for your mercy. We give you praise. Thank you for your compassion. Thank you for your undying, everlasting, liquid love. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen and amen. My name again is Sister Temitayo, and I hope this blessed you. And while you're on my channel, please don't forget to subscribe, and I give you full permission to share this on your social media platforms. And the Lord bless you as you do. Have a good day, and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Don't forget to subscribe.